All right, well, today I'm going to be unboxing an Amazon microphone that I found for $65, I believe. The link will be in the description. But let's go ahead and get right into it. All right. So first here we have a windscreen or a pop filter, whatever. It's pretty high quality. It's got a bendy arm, typical. Alright, now we have a USB 2.0 cable. This is a USB microphone. So this is going to be the USB that you will use to plug from your computer, PS4, or anything into the microphone. We do have a shock filter here. Let's go ahead and get this open. A shock holder. It's pretty high quality. It's made out of metal, and it feels nice and sturdy. Should be holding our microphone really well. And this is for mounting, I believe. So, yep, that'll screw in there, and it's like a little adapter, just in case you need a different size. We have another pop filter. This one's scrunched up. I wish it wasn't scrunched up. I wish there was, you know, like a little cone in here. It's about medium between thick and thin. It's not too bad, I'd say. This is a, I would consider a starter microphone, but of course looks and all, it'll all come down to how the audio sounds. It does come with a clamp, so this is what you'll use to clamp it onto your desk. Looks like this is the bottom here, so once we get into that, I'll show you how I'll clamp it onto my desk. Alright, and then it looks like this is the actual arm. And we'll get into this structure in a moment, but let's go ahead and take a look at the actual microphone. So right off the bat, I can tell that it's heavy, which in my opinion is pretty good because you want a microphone that's built really sturdy. As you can see in there, there's a circle there, and that's how the audio of your voice will get in to the microphone. As you see, like if you have the microphone like this as compared to this, and you're talking this way compared to this way, it'll sound really different because it picks up going in these side directions, as you can see that circle in there. But if you're talking into the top, it'll sound like you're further away, and being further away from the microphone will sound completely different. We do have echo and volume knobs here. And then we have our input where we plug that USB in. And it's pretty heavy. It's made, you know, it's made really well. Has a nice sturdy base to it. So let's go ahead and get it all set up. All right, so we're going to be looking at the base of our microphone, which is technically this clamp here. So let's go ahead and get this out of the packaging. Alright, so it's pretty basic, of course. We'll stick the bottom of that microphone stand here. And it's just, you know, you unravel it, it'll be like a screw almost, and you'll unscrew it. And it will be able to have the ability to clamp to a desk. So if you have a desk lip that has room underneath it, this will be perfect for you. On that side over there, as you can see, right here is where I'll be clamping this, so I'm gonna go ahead and get it clamped. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and get this clamp on our desk here. As you can see, it's gonna be unraveled. I'll unravel it some more. It'll fit perfectly right there. And then you will have to screw it on. So hopefully I can go ahead and get that screwed on so it'll be nice and tight. Alright, so the next step is going to be sticking our microphone arm holder, or the arm for the microphone, into our hole here. So there is a little screw on the back that you have to loosen, I'd say. So you can have the ability to put the arm in there. So we're gonna go ahead and stick our microphone arm in there. Go ahead and drop that bad boy in. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and tighten it. Alright, so we have our microphone arm in place and our hole down here. So the next step, of course, would be to get the microphone set up on there. So first, we are going to go ahead and take our shock mount and get this bad boy on. Alright, so before we get our microphone on our microphone stand, I'm gonna show you how to put the microphone in the shock mount. So there are these two prongs here that create a pinching effect to open the circle here. So just go ahead and slide our microphone through here. And it kind of just stops right there because these volume buttons are there. So I'm gonna slide it out a little bit just so we can be able to still use the volume button. So on the microphone itself, there is a volume and an echo button. Of course, we're going to get to the sound of the microphone later. But I have done research in that if you fully turn the microphone all the way down, it does mute it. So keep that in mind. Alright, so we're going to be putting our shock mount on to the microphone arm here. First, you want to go ahead and make sure that this piece, that gold piece right there, is the right top that screws on to our microphone stand here. And you're just gonna go ahead and screw this on. All right, and we have her on. So our next step, of course, is going to be putting our microphone in. Alright, and I just showed you guys how to do that. So we're going to find our pinch clips here. We'll go ahead and just drop her in. Alright, so this is what it looks like while it is inside of the shock mount. It looks pretty sturdy, pretty stable, really mobile. As you can see here, we can be moving it back and forth, up and down. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this installed. I'm gonna go ahead and put both filters on the windscreen and pop filter. So let's go ahead and just slide this on so I can show you what it looks like with the pop filter on. That's what it looks like. Kind of looks kind of raggedy just because that filter was not perfectly formed in the box. Then I will go ahead and show you how to put the windscreen on. So the windscreen has this V shaped here, just so you would put the barrel of your microphone arm on it. So it'll clip on right here, and then you just kind of screw it on. So you can see if I can go ahead and move to the side here. So I'm gonna have it like this. It'll scoop under like that. And then you kind of want to make sure you're screwing onto a flat edge and not the curve. And I will see you guys when we test the audio on this bad boy. Alright guys, now we are using the microphone audio, and I as well have another audio attached to my neck, so we can go ahead and compare the two sounds. Right now I'm about a hand away from the windscreen, so this is what it sounds like as I'm talking regularly. If you want to go ahead and lean back, I'm guessing you can hear a sound difference that I'm leaning back, still using the same voice level, but as you can tell, I got closer again. So this is what it sounds like. The volume knob is at medium, so we can go ahead and play around with that to see what it sounds like. So this is what it's like when it's all the way up and increasingly getting up there. Still talking at a regular inside voice like I'm on a podcast. And this is what it sounds like when it's lower. So this is less than halfway. As you can see, there is not much pickup for this microphone. As you have to remember, you have to talk into the what would be the sides of the microphone. So go ahead, you would have to play around with your settings here. Yes, so this is actually what it sounds like with it less than halfway. And this is what it sounds like when it's more than halfway. And this is what it sounds like immediate in the halfway mark. So you just have to go ahead and play around with it. It's a pretty good microphone. I'll drop the link in the description. And thanks for watching. She asked me if I do this every day, I said often. That's how many times she wrote the wave, not so often. Bitch, down to do it either way.